Aujourd'hui, nous allons voir les articles, les bases des articles définis, indéfinis. So today, we are going to see the basic articles. Article défini, defined articles and indefined articles. So for each noun, we have to place an article before a noun. Okay, so here you have defined articles. So defined articles is le, la, le, L apostrophe. So L apostrophe. So le, la, le, L apostrophe. It defines the in English. For example, you have masculine for le, la, feminine, plural. We are going to use le. And if you have bubble nouns, so a noun started with a bubble. So for started with a bubble, we are going, if it is masculine or feminine. No worries if it is masculine or feminine. For that we are going to put L apostrophe. And here for article and défini. Les articles and défini, which is not defined. So for that we have un, une, des. So un it is for masculine noun, une for feminine noun, des for plural noun. And it is the meaning of un, une, des in English is a for common thing. And I gave you some example over there. So to differentiate which article we are going to put, so we have to know whether the noun is feminine or masculine, or if it is a belonging to someone or it's a common thing. So belonging to someone we are going to put article défini. If it is a common thing, we are going to use article and défini. So here I am given some example. So le chien. So le chien is a masculine noun. So as I told you, each noun has a gender, masculine or feminine. Anything can be masculine or feminine in French. It is used in French. So le chien is a masculine noun. So I have given the meaning of the dog. So le chien de Manuel. So the dog of Manuel. So le, it is the dog of Manuel. So un chien, it's a dog. Un chien. If you see a dog on the road, it's a dog. That's it. So la porte. La porte, it's a door. The door. If you have a door in your classroom. So this is la porte. It's a common thing. Une porte. So porte is a feminine noun. So we have to know for each lesson you have a vocabulary words list. We have the French meaning along with the English meaning in the book. So you have to buy the book soon so that you will be able to understand what are the meaning of these words. So la porte, une porte. Now les stylos. We already saw these words in your first book. So previous year you saw these basic words. Les stylos. Les stylos. So stylo means pens. So if you have one pen, it's un stylo. It is masculine. So if you have les stylos, it is plural. So first you have to know whether the noun is masculine or plural, feminine. Next. L'école. L'école. Why I put L apostrophe here? Because it started with a vowel. So each noun started with a vowel, whether it is masculine or feminine, we are going to put L apostrophe. So here, école, une école. I know that it is masculine. So I am going to put une. And I give another example for masculine noun started with a vowel. So l'arbre means the tree. L'arbre means the tree. It started with the A. So here also you have a vowel. So how I will find if it is a masculine or a feminine noun? You have to go through our vocabulary words list. So that you will be differentiate which noun are masculine, which noun are feminine. So for that I will find out it is a masculine noun. So for that we are going to put an arbre, a tree. If you find a tree over there, you will tell an arbre. Okay, so for each noun we have a article placed before a noun. That is article defini and article indefini. That is for today. I'm going to give you some words and you are going to find out which are the articles which are going to place before these nouns. I'm going to give you as a homework. So you are going to fill up this as a filler. And then I'm going to give you a topic. Please find out the articles. And if I'm giving you article defini, you're going to write only the article defini. If I'm going to give you article indefini, you're going to fill up with the article indefini and you're going to find out the word if it is masculine, feminine, and for plural. You don't have to find out the articles because we already have a S for each plural noun. So you don't worry about this. These two will won't have to worry about this. These two only we are going to find if it is masculine or feminine. So I am going to give you some exercise and you are going to go through this exercise along with the lesson that I taught you. Thank you.
Bonjour. Aujourd'hui nous allons voir les verbes du premier groupe, les verbes qui se terminent en ER. So les verbes du premier groupe se terminent en ER. So pour ça, pour conjuguer un verbe du premier groupe, tout d'abord nous allons voir les pronoms sujets. Qu'est-ce qu'un pronom sujet? So, to conjugate the verb for the first group verb, for all the first group verb end with the ER. So, to conjugate a verb for the first group, first we have to know the subject pronoun. What are the subject pronoun that we are going to use for each verb? So, je, tu, il, elle, nous, vous, il, elle. So, I have given the English translation for each pronoun subject. So, je, why I put J apostrophe here? It is because, for example, we have bubble. A verb started with a bubble. So, for that we are going to put J apostrophe. So, je cannot be placed before a bubble. So, I have written je and J apostrophe together. So, je means I. Tu, you. Il, he. Elle, she. Nous, we, vous, you, il, elle, commonly we have to say they for masculine plural and feminine plural. And here you have two you. So it is used, this you for, between friends. This is used between friend and this is for elder one. This is used for elder one. So this use we can use form informally and this is formally. Sorry. So now we are going to see the verb conjugation. So un verbe qui n'est pas conjugué ne s'appelle infinitif. Un verbe qui n'est pas conjugué s'appelle infinitive. A verb without conjugation is called infinitive. So I have written the infinitive verb here. If you are going to cut the ER, the ending of the first group verb. So we are going to cut the ER, the part of this verb. It is called le radical. So the half part of this verb, it is called le radical. So, la terminaison des verbes du premier groupe. The endings of the verb of the first group verb. So, here I have written ER group verb ending. So, these endings are commonly used for this. For each subject, you have to put the ending. So, E for je, ES for tu, E for il, E for L, O N S for nous, E Z for vous, E N T for il plural, L plural. So here I have given you one example of
which is called the verb parler. Parler is to speak or to talk. Okay, so I have given the subject pronoun this side. In front of each verb you have a subject pronoun. So I have written par. You can see here I made a difference between the verb and the endings. So je parle, I speak. So at the end of this you are going to add the ending of each subject. Okay, so je parle, tu parles, il parle, elle parle, nous parlons, vous parlez, il parle, elle parle. So it is a conjugation of the first group verb. And here another example I have given with a verb starting with a vowel. So as I told you, je become J apostrophe before a vowel. So here I have written J apostrophe because here you have a vowel. It is only for je, not for the other subject. So J apostrophe becomes J apostrophe. J'aime, I like. Tu aimes, il aime, elle aime. Nous aimons, vous aimez, il aime, elle aime. So you can see the difference between these two verbs. So here you have je and here you have J apostrophe before a vowel. So that is for the first group verb, ER group verb, which is the how to conjugate a first group verb. So I am going to give you some homework with these verbs. I am going to give you few new verbs. So you have to write the verbs conjugation according to the lesson that I taught you. Thank you.
Nous allons voir la première leçon du livre. Là, à la rentrée, at the school reopening. Okay, this is the title of the first lesson. So, we have three dialogues in this lesson. So, first we are going to go for the first dialogue. Dialogue A. Dialogue A. Dialogue B. Dialogue C. Vous avez trois conversations. So, first dialogue. I am going to read the first dialogue in French. So, je vais lire en français. Et après, vous avez la traduction en anglais en bas. So, Vinay, salut Nishan, ça va? Oui, ça va. Et toi? Ça va bien. Au revoir. It is a small conversation between Nishan and Vinay. Okay, so here is the translation for that. Hi Nishan, you are fine?
Yes, I am fine. And you?
I am fine, well. Goodbye. Okay, so this is over for the dialogue. So maintenant nous allons passer au dialogue B. Sunny est le professeur. Sunny est son professeur. So, oh pardon Sunny, bonjour. So you have to put that tone, okay, so that you can understand the dialogue. So, ah, c'est toi Anwar?
Non monsieur, je suis Sunny.
Oh pardon Sunny, ça va?
Oui, ça va bien, monsieur. Et vous?
Ça va.
Au revoir, Sunny.
Au revoir, monsieur. Okay, so this is a conversation between Sunny and the professor. Okay, so they are meeting each other. So here is the translation for that. Oh, sorry, sir.
Good morning.
Ah, it's you, Anwar. So you can see in your book, you have the translation and the picture along for the translation. So he dropped his book down. So he's asking sorry to his sir. Okay? So that is the conversation.
Ah, it's you, Anwar.
No, sir, I am Sunny.
Oh, sorry, Sunny.
You are fine?
Yes, I am fine, well, sir.
And you?
Fine. Goodbye, Sunny.
Goodbye, sir. Okay, so c'est fini pour ce dialogue. Okay, on va passer au dialogue C. So, avec Arjun et John. So, il y a un dialogue avec Arjun, John et Ravi. Okay, so, salut John, comment ça va?
J'ai oublié le pas.
Jules. Salut John, comment ça va? John il va répondre, ça va bien et toi? Bien, voici un ami. Bonjour, je m'appelle John et toi? Comment tu t'appelles?
Moi, je m'appelle Ravi.
So, ils présentent son ami Ravi. Ok, so il y a un dialogue. There's a conversation between John and Jul. So, and John is presenting his friend Ravi. Ok, so here is a translation for that.
Hey John, how are you?
I'm fine, well.
And you?
Well. Here is a friend. So, voici un ami. Here is a friend. Good morning. So, it's telling good morning to his friend. My name is John. So, John is telling, my name is John, and he is introducing himself. What is your name?
As for me or myself.
You can say as for me or myself. As for me, my name is Ravi. So, they have a conversation between them. So, these are the three dialogues that we are having for lesson number 1. So, you have to go through and write without looking the French English meaning. You are going to read and write the translation at home. Try to write without seeing the English.